This is part 3 of a series on logistic regression. In this video, we will look at the one versus rest OVR method for multi-class classification. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated using AI text-to-speech. In the last two videos, we looked at the binary classification. In this video, we will look at the multi-class classification. First, let's look at the OVR, one versus rest method. And let's implement this using scikit-learn's logistic regression library. Let's take a look at how OVR multi-class classification works. The data below has two features, X1 and X2, and one target Y class or label. The target Y has three types of classes, 0, 1, and 2. One versus rest is a heuristic method that uses multiple binary classification models for multi-class classification, shortly called OVR. OVR is also called OVE or one versus all. Another method is multinomial or softmax logistic regression. This is an algorithmic method that uses the softmax function and the cross entropy loss function. We'll take a closer look at this method in the next video. There are three types of labels in Y, so the data below looks like this. The data points are distributed into three clusters like this. And there will be multiple decision boundaries like this. We transform Y into one hot encoding to perform the multi-class classification using OVR. 0 is converted to 100, and 2 is converted to 001. The first column can be thought of as the probability that Y is 0, the second column as the probability that Y is 1, and the third column as the probability that Y is 2. For the first data point, Y is 0, because the probability that Y is 0 is 100%. For the second data point, Y is 2, because the probability that Y is 2 is 100%. Then each column becomes the data for binary classification consisting of 0 and 1. Let's split this data on the left into three data sets, as shown on the right. Binary classification can then be applied to each data set. We can train each data set using three binary classification models. In this data set, Y is either 1 or 0. Classify the red data points and the remaining data points. This is the decision boundary for the first data set. The second data set can be separated like this. And the third data set can be separated like this. These three models can be used to predict the target class of the test data. Once training is complete, test data points are fed into three models to predict the class probabilities for those test data points. For example, let's say the Y hat from the first model is 0.2. This means there is a 20% chance that Y is 0. And let's say the Y hat from the second model is 0.1. This means there's a 10% chance that Y is 1. And let's say the Y hat from the third model is 0.7. This means there's a 70% chance that Y is 2. Then, since Y is most likely 2, we can predict that the class of the test data point is 2. This is the multi-class classification method using OVR. Now let's implement the OVR multi-class classification using the iris dataset. This data has four features X and one target Y. there are three types of target Y, 0, 1, and 2. The data consists of three clusters like this. Next, let's create three binary classification models that train the iris data with multiple classes and predict the classes or labels of the test data. We will use the Logistic Regression library as a base model. Read iris dataset. X represents four features and Y represents three classes. One hot encode the class Y. Features are from X1 to X4 and one hot encode Y. If Y is 2, it will be converted to 0, 0, 1. Split the data X and encoded Y into the training and test data. Next, we perform OvR. Since Y has three classes, we need three binary classification models. Initialize the models list and repeat the following process as many classes as Y contains. Y train is also one hot encoded. If M is 0, the first column vector is used for the first model. This is the Y subcolumn vector. Create a binary classification model using logistic regression and fit it to the X train and Y sub. If M is 1, this column vector is used. And if M is 2, this column vector is used. This creates three binary classification models. Next, we use these three binary classification models to predict the class Y of the test data. Initialize the Y-prob matrix. The Y-prob matrix looks like this. The number of rows is the number of test data points, and the number of columns is the number of classes Y. Initially, we set them all to 0. Then, the train models are read one by one from the models list. We use the MHEV binary model to predict the class probability of each test data point and update the mth column of Y-prob with this probability. Then it will be updated like this, for example. Next, we use the argmax function to predict the class with the highest probability of Y-prob as the final Y. For the first test data point, the Y will be predicted to be 2. This is because the probability of 0.7 is the highest. Next, we measure the accuracy of the test data. Y-test is also one hot encoded like this. Convert this back to its original class. This is the Y-true vector, which is the actual Y value. Now we measure the accuracy using the actual and predicted Y values. Lastly, let's check the predicted parameters. Let's check the W and B for the three binary models. When the data cluster looks like this, the three binary models would look like this. The parameters of each model are as follows. The Y-hat formula for model 0 is as follows. Since there are four features X, there are four parameters W and one parameter B. The four W values estimated per model are as follows. And there is one B. Other models also have four W's and one B's. The total number of estimated parameters is 15. The accuracy was measured at 0.9. Even if you don't do this, the logistic regression library automatically performs OVR internally. We'll look at this in the following code. Here I coded it like this, using the loop statements to better understand how OvR logistic regression works. Let's run this code. The results came out like this. The accuracy was 0.967, and 15 parameters were estimated. Let's run it one more time. This time the accuracy was measured at 0.867. This time, let's use the multi-class argument of the logistic regression class as OVR. Read the iris dataset and split the data into the training and test data. One hot encoding is not required here. And then we create a logistic regression model. Here we set the multi-class argument to OVR. Then fit this model to the training data. Even without setting OVR, multi-class classification is automatically performed by referring to the number of classes Y. If the classes are 0 and 1, it performs binary classification. And if the number of classes is greater than 2, it automatically performs multi-class classification. OVR is explicitly specified here for clarity. Next, we use this model to predict the class of the test data. And we measure the accuracy of the test data. Lastly, let's check the estimated parameters. The accuracy was measured at 0.967. As in the previous code, there are 12 estimated parameters W. The first row is the parameter W vector of the model 0. The second and third rows are also the W vectors for each model. The W vector for each model has 4 elements from W1 to W4. This is because the number of features is 4. And 3 intercept Bs for each model were also estimated. The total number of parameters is 15, which is the same as the code on the previous page. The logistic regression library makes it easy to implement multi-class classification like this. Let's run this code. The results came out like this. So far, we have implemented OVR multi-class classification using scikit-learn's logistic regression library. In the next video, we will look at how to perform multi-class classification using multinomial logistic regression or softmax regression.